Let's look at how demand response works at a big picture level. Who initiates it, why, and who can participate? Firstly, demand response can assist in managing different conditions in the power system. It could be used because, say, there is a heat wave or a cold snap, spot prices are starting to go sky high, or there are generation outages. It can also be used as a non-transmission solution to defer investment in our infrastructure. Or if Transpower is planning maintenance work and needs to take lines out of service for a period. So let's have a look at the traditional demand-side supply chain in the New Zealand electricity industry. Transpower connects directly with electricity distribution companies, for example, lines companies, who enable load-serving entities, for example, electricity retailers, to sell power to consumers. A curtailment service provider, or CSP, is the term used to describe those who contract directly with Transpower to supply demand response. Let's now look at the participants in our power system, how they interact, and where CSPs fit in. A CSP can be an electricity distribution company, a load-serving entity, a consumer, or an independent entity that combines any of these participants and acts as their agent. An example of this would be a facilities manager of a chain of supermarkets. Transpower will have contracted with one or many CSPs for a guaranteed response for an agreed amount of megawatts in a specific region.